Hi friends, this presentation is on subject GRE, also known as advanced GRE on subject maths. Now this presentation is a part of my 11 day program on subject GRE and a mock test on this day. Now before coming to the presentation, I would like to inform you some facts about the subject exam. Now this exam is very important because it gives you an additional edge which is helpful for you to get financial aid for your MS or PhD program. In this course we also talk about the difficulty level of this program and the time required for preparation to target this exam in November each year. Resources and books recommended for these programs will be shown, and the importance of this exam for management and computer science students will also be explained in details in later parts of this series, and the applicability and usefulness of this exam and its preparation in your graduate research will also be shown. Now ETS has released around 5 tests, the numbers of which are GRE 9768, 9367, 8767 and 0568, and beside that we have got around 5 tests which are released by ACRO, and another very important book which is on cracking the subject exam by Princeton. Okay, now coming to our presentation, this part talks about calculus 2, which is covered on the third day of our 11 day program, and this part is around 20% of the exam. Now the areas covered in calculus part 2 is vector calculus and 3D geometry, various types of coordinate systems, partial differentiation and its interpretation, line integrals, double integrals and Green theorem. Now coming to vector calculus, how do we define a point in three dimension? It is defined on the terms of the distance moved by us on the x, y and z direction respectively. Now suppose we take a point P and we move in x and y and z coordinate at a distance of x naught, y naught and z naught respectively, then our point can be described as x naught, y naught and z naught. In vector calculus we have got two types of multiplication which are derived from Newtonian physics, which are the dot product and the cross product. We generally use dot product to calculate work done in physics. It was derived in a way to calculate the effective force in the direction of which a body is moving, to calculate the work done by that force. Now suppose A dot B. Now a body moves in a direction on the line A, but we applied force in the direction B. So the effective direction of the force will be the component of B in direction A, which will be A cos B cos theta into A. So basically it was defined in physics and now it is used in various other areas. Whenever the vector is perpendicular, then it will have no effect on the other vector, which can be seen in the middle diagram. And if the vector is greater than 90 degree, then it will have a negating effect on the other vector, as shown in the third figure. The scalar and vector products. Now, generally there is a lot of confusion about what exactly does the scalar and vector products mean, how they were derived, what are their implications and how actually we took them. Now suppose we ask a question like y is the multiplication of two vectors A cross B is in the opposite direction. How does the third direction come into play in cross product? The answer to this question is hidden in the way in which this thing was applied to the rotational mechanics. Now, suppose just imagine a point A, and the point is only allowed to rotate in a circular direction around an axis. So, whatever force you are going to apply will be used to rotate the body, because it is only allowed to rotate in an axis, not allowed to move in any other direction. In this case, the maximum effect of your force will only be seen when your applied force will be perpendicular to the axis. So this is how this cross product came into play, and we started using it for various other applications. So basically, cross product means A cross B, which is A into B into sine theta, and the direction is perpendicular to the axis. Now, why perpendicular to the axis? This is because the effect of the force will give a rotational effect, which will be stored as rotational kinetic energy in the body. Therefore, we say that A cross B will have a magnitude which will be perpendicular to the direction of axis and the direction of force applied. Similarly, we can calculate the scalar triple product, which is the volume as shown in the figure. And coming to line in three dimension, now a line in three dimension can be defined as a set of points, which satisfy another point x naught, y naught, z naught, and which has a directional vectors v1, v2, v3. So it is defined as x equal to x naught plus t times v1, y equal to y naught plus t times v2 as shown, and this is how we define a line in three dimension. Now, a plane is defined in three dimension by using a line which is perpendicular to the plane, because that's the only way to move ahead, to define a plane in the simplest way. Because plane is a set of points which lies such that the set of points forms a structure which is perpendicular to a line n and satisfies a point P. So this is how we differentiate a plane. Actually, this idea comes on how we define locus. Now, a plane is the locus of points which satisfies point P and which is perpendicular to line to a line which is perpendicular. So basically, we have got the dot product of the direction cosines into n, which will be equal to 0. Now, the coordinate system in 3D can be cylindrical, where we have got the radius of the cylinder, theta is the angle on which we are rotating, and z is the height of the cylinder. So these are called the cylindrical coordinates. Similarly, we have the polar coordinates, in which we have got a pole at a distance P and the theta and phi as the two angles defining the point. Now, coming to partial differentiation and its interpretation, the partial differentiation means that in our function we have got two variables x comma y, but we keep one variable constant and only change the other variable. For example, in this equation we only change the variable x to x plus h, and keep the other variable y as constant. So in practicality, we perform the common differentiation keeping the other variable as constant. An example is shown, where g is dependent on four other variables and its partial differentiation. Now, Visualization of partial differentiation can be done when we are doing it by changing x, we are keeping y constant, so we will not allow y to change, so we will get a tangent. The directional derivative of the I'll cover this in the next part, and I'll also cover line integrals, double integrals, and Green theorem in the next part, and also I'll have another separate series on differential equations, and these are the references from where you can study about subject GRE. Okay, thank you and have a nice day ahead.